My Titan Fitness 1,000-pound adjustable bench is going back to the manufacturer. I'm returning it for two main reasons. The first reason would have been overlooked if not for the second. Before I get into the reasons though, I want to mention that Titan Fitness customer service has been excellent throughout the process. They tried to remedy the situation twice. First by sending me some miscellaneous parts, which didn't quite work out. And second time they actually sent me a whole new bench to see if that would resolve the issue. And unfortunately it didn't. So despite their customer service, which is excellent, it's just not enough to overcome the big shortcoming of this product for me. So the main reason, and I think we're beating this one to death because I mentioned it in three of my previous videos about this bench, but it has to do with the adjustable frame back here. The whole 1,000-pound rating on this bench is dependent on two bolts. One going through the pivot point right here, and the next one going through the pivot point right here. This frame, should anything happen to this bolt, basically will shear right off and the bench will collapse. Now, for those of us that are benching heavy weight over our heads, necks, that's just making me sketched out. And I may be paranoid because I've seen other benches with this design, but I just don't think it's smart. I don't know where these bolts came from. The bench is obviously manufactured in China. I just don't trust it. First of all, they're not long enough, so the nut only captures a couple threads in both locations, so they could come loose. Second of all, you can see how short these notches are, so you know it's unlikely but possible that this frame would skip, especially given the fact that it's not even aligning correctly with the notches. So this whole situation back here for me is just not safe. I'm not willing to risk it. I think there's better benches out there for a little bit more money. Continuing with the safety theme, let's talk about this pop pin down here. Again, the whole 1,000-pound rating of this bench is dependent on this pin. Let's take a closer look at it.
Okay, here we are under the bench. And when I pull this pop pin out for you, you could see how chewed up, thin, and weird looking it is. The shaft. I have not used this bench for more than a week, and for sure that's not my doing. So 1,000 pounds is resting on this janky looking pin. That's not cool.
The second reason, and like I said, I would have overlooked this had it not been for my safety concerns, is the overall length of the bench. Unfortunately, loft gym is not that big, and this bench is just too long. You could see how far the rollers and the front feet stick out past the pad. That adds a lot of extra length, which would be the case if it was just straight legs over here. So it's just too big for the space. I would have overlooked that if I had other good warm and fuzzies about the bench, but I just don't. To sum up, you get what you pay for. And the $145 is just not enough money to spend on the quality home adjustable bench, especially with a 1,000-pound rating. So I'm gonna look elsewhere and I'll let you know what new bench I end up with. Thanks for watching.